I don't know if you want to put that on an angle.
Yeah, do you want to like...
Yeah. Yeah, so we can kind of lean.
Against the wall.
Yeah.
Do you want to put your...
Yeah. Oh, it's recording already.
I was
Yeah, it's okay. Well, I was gonna like listen to like Dupper's like
half. Poking around. All right. So for most of you, it will be a new training. For Lindsay, it's a review. So we'll go product by product. Some of the product you don't have on your shelf, and like I said, some of the product in the book. It's a book from the United States. Some of the product we don't have for a certain reason in Canada. So I'll tell you exactly which product you or you don't, and what is the reason for. Because some of the product is because of the legal FDA and Santé Canada, it's like about like the FDS product and all of those. So we'll do product by product because we do have only 2 hours. So I'm going to go through all the philosophy and the company because it will take much too long for you. So product by product. Okay, so the first one you can go and it's skincare and we'll go with the aloe cleansing gel. Maybe you can get some tissue or garbage bin because we're going to play around with the product. So this one, I guess for you it's a good seller.
Really good. It's like a price.
Yes.
People really like it. It's a cleanser that we have to use with water. We put just a little bit because a bit goes a very long way. If we put too much, it will foam a lot. It's not a big foam, but it will be too foamy and it will be very hard to remove. There's no sulfate in it. The emulsifier is coconut oil. So it doesn't dry out your skin. And the aloe vera is 50% of the oil concentration of the oil ingredients. So it's very, very concentrated in aloe vera. Good for all skin types. Usually normal to combination or oily skin would prefer a gel, but even if we do have a dry or very sensitive, the aloe will really calm down the inflammation. So it's for all skin types and amazing for baby skin.
One day maybe you come and then
if you have oily or pregnant, you can sell that product as a cleanser for all skin, the baby skin.
Thank you so much.
You're all set?
Thank you for this. No problem.
So I have any question on that product?
Yeah.
So for everyone, it's a good seller. It sells by itself. The chamomile cleansing milk.
My sister was so sweet.
This one is for all skin type. Between the gel and the milk, what is your recommendation for a skin, usually?
Oh, like milk for dry?
Yeah.
Sensitive?
Yeah. Right. But
I have just some clients, they would never use gel, they just want a milk or...
That's about it. Yeah. It. The question with your client is what the client prefer as a cleanser. Usually a milk will go for a normal to more dry skin, but even that chamomile milk have a moringa seed extract that is antibacterial. So even for oilier skin or with impurities, it can be used without any problem because it's antibacterial. And even the lavender inside, there's an extract lavender inside. This one will have the antiseptic action too.
It won't give you a gratuity.
Both of these cleansers, they can be used over eye without any problem, but for sure it's not to remove waterproof eye makeup. There's something else for that. It can be the gel in summertime, the winter in the milk in wintertime. It all depends on your client.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. The oat polish. Can you tell me how you're selling that product to your consumer?
As an exfoliant.
Okay. Great. For daily exfoliant?
It depends on the skin type.
You're right.
Yeah. If they're just a little super sensitive, they might want to use less.
Yeah. And if they have a thicker skin, it can be used every day without any problem with those little particles, which are
jojoba.
Jojoba. I will say it in French. Jojoba.
Oh, it's so nice. Much nicer.
It's jojoba beef.
Oh, that sounds so much better.
So fancy. Yes, okay, so yes, as a daily exfoliator or 2-3 times a week, depending on the skin, it can be used too as a mask. You use a thicker coat and you leave it on for 5 to 10 minutes. Or it can even be used as a gommage.
Oh really?
So you put a very, very light coat.
Yeah. Give me a little. Just tiny. Yeah.
Put a very light coat. Yeah. Leave it for 5 minutes about, just to let it dry. Yeah. And then we can make like a gommage or a scrub, whatever you prefer the word. For normal, not sensitive skin. If it's a sensitive skin, you better put a thicker coat and just smooth these jojoba beads very lightly. Did you ever experience on some very, very sensitive or dehydrated skin, any of your consumers said, oh my God, it was tingling on my skin?
Yes.
You already had that before.
Yeah.
So if a skin is very, very dehydrated, the best way to use it is to put just a little bit in the palm of your hand and put a drop or two of water and emulsify it. Just a little bit, just to work that product and emulsify it. It will help to moisturize the product and make the skin more acceptable. So. It's an amazing product. That's a nice one too for chapped lips. I know you have your lip balm, but you can sell that for as a face product, but it can be sold too as a lip treatment. So you put like this thick coat, you leave it for 5 minutes, then you rub it so it will remove those little skins on the lips. That's perfect for this time of the year when everything is dry. And are you doing the scrub?
Yeah, sorry.
It's nice, huh?
Yeah, but my hand is like ridiculously dry right now.
But the scrub or the gommage, it's nice to sell it that way on a very experienced woman or consumer. Because if you sell as a gommage to a new consumer who had never done that, they won't like this
technique. Really nice.
But if you want a stronger,
like really
it's
nice. Gommage,
Do yours roll off as much?
Yeah,
well, I do for quite some time. I have as much dry skin.
It's so nice.
It didn't peel up. It was like not dry enough.
No, it did, but like, you know, when I rubbed it, it didn't fall off as much. But even when I'm used as mitt things, like people say skin comes off, and I'm like, no.
You have a good natural exfoliation process.
That's great for you.
I think so. So that's a beautiful product to sell to everyone. The only skin type or condition that is not the skin type or condition for that product, it's very oily to acneic skin. Because it's old, so it's not rich, but it is nourishing. And you don't want acne with open pimples or impurities to get those jojoba beads inside of the pimples. So they better use the pumpkin exfoliator. But this one is, for a very sensitive skin, it's amazing for exfoliation. Okay, now we're at mist. These mists are like the other brand toners, but the only difference that there are no alcohol at all inside, and it can be used, well, it has to be used before applying the serum and cream, but it can be used too during the day, any time of the day, or with or without makeup, just to refresh the skin, to give those ingredient to treat the skin and to uplift the mood too, because there is essential oils, so there is an action on the mood too. So it's a bit different than a regular toner, and it has to be sprayed like about 30-40 centimeters to the face. So even with makeup, and it can fix makeup, you're working with Jarnardia. Are you using these over the makeup?
Delicious.
Amazing.
Like in the middle of
I do it like sometimes two times. It's like it's hot here and it's
good. Yeah, it treats the skin, it refresh, and the lavender, honey lavender on the mood will help to calm down and to de-stress. On the skin, what it will do is calming, but it is also antiseptic and antimicrobial. So this one is for all skin type, but more especially for normal to oily or acne skin. Because you have different ingredients, you have the flower water inside of the lavender, because when they do the distillation, they boil those lavender plants, and what is coming as the most concentrated part is the essential oil of it. So the oil will help there to calm down the skin and to soothe the skin, but the residual water will have an antiseptic action on the skin. So that's why it's good for acne skin. And as we know, honey, even when we have a sore throat, I said it would. Just to take a spoon of honey will help to combat those microbes into the throat. So it's the same thing, the honey extract has the antimicrobial action on pimples and impurities. You're gonna tell me which one you like most.
I already know.
Yeah.
Which one?
Sorry. I like the rose geranium.
The rose geranium, yeah, it's very nice. The smell of it.
Don't spray it, it's kind of coming out as well.
Like a one big one?
Yeah, one big one. Yeah. Yeah, I like the rose geranium too. I like both, but yeah. Geranium's a fan of geranium.
Yeah, I like the rose.
Nice and anti-aging.
Yeah. It's anti-aging.
Oh, I'll just keep it.
And the concentrate part of the geranium oil, the essential oil, so the awesome. Geranium will help to strengthen the blood capillaries. Mm-hmm. So it's mostly more for dehydrated, sensitive, and blood circulation problem, or just cuprose, or even the rosacea, it's more like a medical problem, but it helps to calm down and to reinforce the blood capillaries. I'm doing my
gommage
now.
Okay.
And this one will have on the mood an uplift effect, so it will just give more energy and boost to the mood. During the day, it's a first product to solve. So they can have one in the morning at home with their routine of beauty, and they can bring one with them in their purse or just to put beside the computer at work. So that's very nice. The Aloe Replenishing Mask. One of the most beautiful product of the line. And a pump, not the better of the line. I just ordered a new one because my other one was not working anymore. I hope they will change the pump.
I find these not the best pumps or sprays, but good product.
You had it before, but it was kind of removed of the list of product that Pure and Simple is having. So I think they probably
trial things and see how well they sell.
Yeah, maybe. I don't know if it's because of the palm, because I didn't talk to Tina about it.
It smells really good.
I
think
it.
You do
want me.
Sorry?
It's
no, they like it.
Yeah, it smells the prickly pear cactus extra. Wow. That's the smell of it. This one is like a big glass of water for any skin type or condition. Mm.
Do you know how much
it's selling for? I think it's quite
expensive. Wait, it's 60,
right? Not as huge. Not as much as this.
Oh, okay. Yeah. They have a thing because it's, you don't have that many glasses.
Mm. I like the feel of it.
Yeah. Yeah, it's amazing. The way to use it, it's just, even in our treatment like protocol, every time we do a peeling or a pumpkin or glycolic or whatever pumpkin, peeling that we use, after removing the peeling, we always use this as a 2-3 minute mask just to calm down the skin, because aloe inside will really help to soothe and calm the skin. The prickly pear cactus will moisturize, and there is some hyaluronic acid inside too. It's like the most calming and hydrating product. It's not nourishing, it's just like a big glass of water. So any skin type that needs that hydration, it's amazing. It's a gel, so a gel, we leave it for 10 to 15 minutes maximum. If we want to go sleep with that kind of mask, it's kind of like not very comfortable. So there's a way to use it as a night mask. It's to use it with all of the rosehip seed oil or ruby carrot seed oil. So if we want to keep it, let's say, all night long, we just put a little drop of this oil. Change completely the texture of it. You can get it.
So this is the carrot oil, or?
This one is the carrot oil, but it can be mixed with any oil.
Yeah.
So this way, we can use it, apply it, and leave it for the night, and we won't feel that uncomfortable tightening effect of the gel by itself. Any sunburn, amazing. Any insect bite, amazing. So hopefully they're gonna change that awful pump and you will be able to get it again. But ask it if you want to have it, and you, if you think it's a good seller for you, ask Gina.
So
I think they might reorder it if your client asking for that. Okay, is there another product that you're looking that I didn't talk about, because we're not having
Oh no, I'm just looking at that going next page, okay. Right. And I don't think we have the masks here.
Yeah, the white tea mask.
Yeah.
Do we?
Yeah,
we do.
Oh, we do.
No, we don't carry the white tea mask.
No, we don't.
No, we used to have it.
We used to have the green tea.
We used to have the green tea mask. We only have the moss blend.
You have the moss blend.
Yes.
You don't have that one anymore. Some of the location they do.
Oh, okay. We can go over.
Yeah, we can go over.
I thought we did that.
We did.
You did.
Yeah. So we get rewarded.
Yeah, you should just ask for it. So that's our anti-aging antioxidant mask. It's a creamy mask.
Yeah. I would have facial after, so.
There is some borage oil.
Am I saying it right?
Yeah. Okay, the borage seed oil will really reinforce and repair the cell membrane. And the white tea extract has that anti-inflammatory and free radical killing effect. So it's boosting, it's regenerating the skin and like controlling those free radicals to harm the skin. And because of the white tea extract, and there is an extract of rosemary, it's not in the principal ingredient, but you can see in the inky list, the rosemary extract will give that lifting effect. So, yeah, it's nourishing and anti-aging, but a very brightening and lifting effect. So that's an amazing mask to sell as a before going out mask. The wedding mask.
Yeah.
The date mask. So first of all, you do your exfoliation or pumpkin or cherry or whatever enzyme pot, enzyme peels, and then you apply your white tea mask to get that uplifting and brightening effect. So, and for more mature skin, I would use it like 2-3 times a week, depending the time of the client. Because this one you could do every day, no problem, on more mature skin. The only type of skin we're not going to use that one is oily or acne skin because it's too nourishing. But the aloe replenishing mask, this one is amazing for combination or even acne skin, the one that we saw before.
This hand's going to be in really good shape.
So, cleanser, if we do a little recap or the and I'm talking about all the product from the Hydrate and Protect line. We do have another cleanser in the Firming Lift, but if we make a little recap, which cleanser will go for a normal to oily skin?
Either.
That's it.
Yeah.
It depends. The base or the preference.
What texture they like.
Exactly. And which one we can sell as a baby skin cleanser?
The yellow gel.
Yeah.
All
right. If I want to treat acne skin, which of the mist is the best?
Better.
And what are the ingredients that will be good for them?
Lavender.
Yeah.
And honey.
Oh, yeah! Exactly, for antiseptic. Great, all right. Good, so it's okay with the cleanser, the mist, and the mask. Great. And now I'll go to the, the carrot seed.
You know, coming with those face oils.
Oh, I know, because you have a lot in your
oils.
I know about it. Okay, yeah. I'll just make it try because it's amazing. The smell of it.
I wish it had this fudgy like carrot seed oil.
The carrot seed,
amazing to that.
So is it carrot seed essential oil in a carrier?
A little bit of
it's not essential oil. It's the seed oil.
Just carrot seed oil. Okay.
Carrot seed oil?
Sometimes people do carrot seed essential oil in a carrier, right?
No, it's
just carrot seed oil.
The seed oil, and there is a primrose seed oil too in that formulation. So the smell of it.
Primrose?
That's the most.
That's very angry.
Yeah, because it repairs the cell membrane.
Carrot seed oil is excellent.
But we don't sell
beta carotene.
That oil as our end.
Okay, did you not the market?
Even if it works very well.
What did you sell it for?
For dull, dry,
calming, soothing, anti-inflammatory, eczema, psoriasis.
Psoriasis,
yeah. Sorry, that's a kind of
thing
that I can't.
I knew what you meant. Okay, so you don't need the facial. But it's also anti-aging, so it's so nice, so versatile.
Yeah, it is.
Okay. I'd say put it with the rose hip together.
Okay.
But it penetrates beautifully.
Yeah. Those oils are amazing because they are not sticky.
Yeah.
They are not too much oily.
Yeah.
And it's to be used or under cream or by itself at night. Not by itself during daytime because it's like a serum. It goes right through into the skin.
Mm-hmm.
But for nighttime, that could be great.
Yeah.
And it's, the soothing effect of it is just amazing. And someone that is not comfortable to use that kind of texture, the best way to use it in that case is you put your one or two drop.
Emulsify it.
Yeah, that's it. And
you put gel hydrosol and it emulsifies the oil and it penetrates into the
pores. And it goes right to in the skin with the mist. So even your skin oil, you can sell those mists, or if you have any pure and simple mist, you can sell it like that so it goes faster into the skin.
I usually use, like, after I put on, like, I use my toner and then I put my serum, my oil, my moisturizer, and then I water it in again.
It really helps after treatment.
Yeah,
it really does. Yeah.
Water it in like a plant.
Exactly.
That's it. Yeah. To grow like a plant.
Yeah.
So, yes. That primer was extract had the anti-aging impact because it's really like free radicals and it's very rich in vitamins A, omega-3, omega-6, but in that case, it's more like the anti-inflammatory and soothing effect.
Well, they're all the oils sort of
they're repairing.
They're
repairing, that's about it. And the primrose, eye contour, you have that one?
Yep.
How you sell the eye contour? Which, like, age parts, age segment you're visiting with?
Anyone who's concerned with anything.
So anybody, anyone over 30.
You're concerned by what?
Yeah.
Anything. Okay.
Anything. I sell it like if they're concerned with wrinkles, then.
Yeah, wrinkles, but more wrinkles from dehydration and first sign of aging. Because there's a natural peptide in it that will help to boost collagen production, but mostly it's hydration for the eye contour and for the lip contour. And it says lip contour, but it can go on directly on the lip. That's the most universal eye cream. In our line, it goes to everyone, any needs. But it's not specific for dark circle, or it's not specific for more mature skin. We have something else for that. But this one is the most hydrating eye contour cream.
So this is dilute sebum production, but that would help with people that would get the milia then
Where do you see it back?
It's like the second point.
The
second dot.
Akai?
Under key ingredients, the second dot.
Has the ability
to ability to dilute sebum production.
Oh, I don't have the same page as you.
You have.
Great.
You got a different page.
It's for all needs. I would need to take that one and take my note back in that new one. That's great.
Yeah.
So we found another action with the product. If it dilutes, for sure it's for me. Yeah, it's amazing. Yeah, sometimes because some eye contour cream are so rich that they create milia. So we don't want that.
It's a good selling point.
Now we know.
Yeah.
And the other product in the hydrating effect is our lip balm. I think you know. Do you?
Yeah.
This one?
Yeah,
you do? All right. You know already that product.
Yeah,
it smells so good.
It's honey. Honey extract, natural honey extract, and it's mango butter and shea butter together. Mango butter is four times more nourishing than the
shea butter, but all together it makes such a beautiful treatment for the lips. So if we want to make
so good.
A lip therapy treatment at home, let's say we want to have the best of it, the oat polish facial. So we put it, you leave it for 5 minutes, it's enough. We just scrub it. And then, if you want to have the best of the best, we'll get the Primrose Eye Contour and Lip Contour, put it on the lips, then finish with that one. But if you sell those three products just for lips, you may have some certain client that will sell you crazy. But if they already have the oat polish and the Primrose, sell that and pop down with the slow, like mini facial gloves for lips and sweetness. Okay. Any questions? Any concerns?
No.
Okay.
Very good.
Now, in the moisturizer, the Beach Tree. I think you already had it.
We
had did. It. I think we sold out of it.
I think we don't carry it anymore after we sold out of it.
Beach Tree moisturizing cream. The Beach Tree extract will have that oxygenating impact on the cells, on the skin, and it will reactivate the aquaporins. Did you ever heard about aquaporins?
Nope.
Aquaporins are, I don't know if it's written in the same way in your book than in mine, but aquaporins are little natural panels that allow the moisture, the water, to go through the different layer of the epidermis.
What is it called?
Aquaporins.
Porins.
Aqua.
Yeah, it's very nice.
How do we spell it?
A-Q-U-A-P-O-R-I-N-E-S.
Aquaporins. Okay, I'll look that up.
There are natural water communication canals, and this extract will really help to reinforce that water communication in between the different layers of the epidermis. So it's moisture and skin barrier protection. There's triallos inside, the natural sugar, that will make like a little shield to prevent from water loss. So we moisture, we boost our moisture natural process, and we cover with a shield to prevent water loss. So mostly it's hydration. For who? Dehydrated, normal to dry. Because normal to oily, it's good in winter time, but when it's hot outside, that shield protection on a normal to oily skin. I run, I jog, and I remember one morning I used that one before going to jog at 30 outside. Mm-hmm. That was too much. But in winter time or in normal time, that's perfect. Mm-hmm. So any skin that needs moisture, hydration and moisture. When you don't know which moisturizer to sell, that's a good one. Mm-hmm. Except for more oily skin. Are we on Kisses or can I do that? Kisses is black currant. Mm-hmm. You have that one?
Yes.
When we open the jar, it smells like when we open a jar of vitamin. It really smells the vitamin. And it's the vitamin B complex. That it's a powerful antioxidant complex that will detoxify the skin. This is our urban detox cream.
It smells like I think it smells like yogurt.
Yogurt?
Yeah.
Probably because of the cassis, it's
kind of
fruity.
Creamy and fruity.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, I'm like, come yeah. I have a facial after
you're so smart though, because you did the face instead of the hand.
Yeah. Well, I'm softening it up to sherry.
There you go.
Wait, so my blackheads
will
come out better.
It's a very, very light. Yeah, and it's a very, very light texture. Mm-hmm. So even for normal, it has to be
yeasty.
Oily.
It's also yeasty.
Yeah.
Yeast.
Yeah.
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 It is.
Yeah. We'll get a yeast extract. Yeah. Like Vegemite.
Yeah. Not so good to sell it like that.
No.
Let's stay away from the smell.
And there is 10% of the hyaluronic acid inside.
Oh, nice.
So it really helps to treat like first sign of aging, that plumping effect.
Like even menopausal skin acid is really good. So they're breaking out, but then they need the moisture.
That's it in a very light cream, and that vitamin B complex that is detoxifying will help to control those hormonal impurities, because it's not from those hormonal breakouts are not from tumor sebum. They're mostly more from and chronic inflammation.
Yeah.
So that vitamin B extract will really help to control that. That's not for oily skin, but it will help on hormonal disorder.
Yeah.
Absolutely. And and the other cream, it's our most selling cream.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I think people love to put this on their toast in the morning. And I know I'm very Frenchy the way I say it, calendula.
Mm-hmm. It's not so much for your
things.
When I was with Naturopathica in the meeting with all the American girls and we were talking about some ingredient, they were like, oh my god, it's so beautiful from your
mouth.
Yeah,
it is.
Like, oh.
Everything sounds better
especially
when you're so
American.
Yeah.
Yes. So the calendula cream, it's our calming, soothing, anti-irritation, anti-inflammation cream. It seems like a very, very thick texture. It is, but it goes in so fast. So any of these creams can be applied one over the other one and over the other. But they can be applied morning and night.
I just had on a few clients which they had little thicker skin.
Yeah.
Kind of sick on the skin. I had to like kind of work it in more than any other cream.
Okay.
I don't know.
Then you can use it at night, or if they have some problem to work it in, they can put a little bit in their palm of their hand and mix it with the mist.
Yeah, I did.
Just
emulsion
it, and then it will go faster.
Yeah, I can see what you mean. It's the only one that actually did this.
It's more like a thick texture.
Yeah.
So it can be used morning and night, but some skin will prefer using it at night.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
I like it.
I've never actually used it on my own face.
Yeah, nor have I.
I tried it, that's why I did it.
This hand is just doing so amazing.
I have to do
both starting now.
Yeah, now you're going with the anti-aging line.
Right?
On the other hand.
Okay, let's compare now. La la.
Let's work on your hand wrinkles.
Yes.
Because today, after my mini drink, you will have to choose one product that I will send to you as a gift. Because you are so good that you need to be récompensé.
How do you even choose, right?
Actually, there's two that I've tried.
Oh, the vitamin
size. Oh yeah,
but then
they've
got this new line.
And then I just finally tried the vitamin K.
I really
like the vitamin K.
I don't like the bottle of that. I'm gonna be honest. I prefer
it's
like a jar, because I bought it and half of it got wasted because the pump was not working
properly. It's in a tube.
It's in a
tube. Now it changed. When I bought it, it was like a pump. It was terrible.
Yeah, half of the eye creams.
That's the primrose, I think it's not done yet, but it will fall.
No, it's in a tube. We have it now.
The primrose?
Yeah.
Oh, great. Mine is not.
I literally had to do anything.
Okay, so the anti-aging line, smooth and firm. With the cleanser, the Sweet Lupine Cleansing Cream. So this one.
Makeup remover and cleansing cream.
Exactly. That's the only one that is a makeup remover and cleansing cream. So if we do have a lot of eye or face makeup, we can use that one and as a pre-cleanser and then followed by the aloe gel. But this one.
Oh, this is just like a pre-cleanse?
No, that's a pre-cleanser. But let's say you have a very oily skin and you wear a lot of makeup. Mm-hmm. This one is very rich, so you will emulsify the excellence of your makeup to really remove it and then use the aloe gel to have that fresh and clean.
Oh, okay.
That's ylang ylang.
It's like a little
Yeah, there's some ylang ylang. Exactly. And the inkiness you can see. You can smell too.
Sometimes it's too much.
Yeah, because the overbearing.
So it's like somebody wants to do like double cleanse.
Like the symptoms change.
But if not, by itself, it's amazing for any dry skin or more mature skin. I just say for oily skin as a pre-cleanser because they can use it by itself. But they will never feel as clean as when they use it. So that's why. It can be going on together, but because the cleansing gel will clean the skin, emulsify the excess of sebum, but sometimes if we're making a lot of makeup, we need something
creamy or oil.
Because it's hard to remove with just a cleansing lemon juice, so
aloe, and I might take this every time you drink water, put some of this aloe.
And that's the one that in treatment room, in our protocol, we always use that one to remove the eye and the makeup, because it's really dissolved.
I need a new cleanser for makeup because it's so dry.
Okay, and for dry skin, it's amazing because the Sweet Lupine Protein will really, it's a fibroblast booster for collagen, but let's say it's a cleanser.
Yeah, right.
But you have that like nourishing and regenerating effect of that protein from the lupine.
So
and because there's mango extract inside, so the mango would give that rich texture, very comfortable.
And I've been like, you name it, I've done it, but now I actually got like all the peptides.
Hair pig polish. The enzyme peels are the pear one, or the cherry one, or the pumpkin one, as a common ingredient, which is the lactic acid.
Covering my eyes.
There are some different size of acids, different size of molecule. This one is in the medium size. If we were talking about salicylic acid, it's a bigger size of molecule, so it stays more on the top of the skin. The glycolic acid, it's the smallest one. It goes right through the deeper layer of the epidermis. And the lactic acid just go in between. So for that exfoliating effect, it's amazing. So all those three products has that lactic acid extract. Plus, this one here has that hair puree enzyme in it. And fit will give that moisturizing effect. So this one is for more mature or dehydrated skin.
No, that's smart. I can try to be a hero, but at the end of the day.
how to work it. All the enzyme peel, we put a coat astic as this at home. We leave it for 3 to 5 minutes. Let the enzymes do their little pad and jump. Get all of those dead cells, not eaten, but broken and removed. And the best way to use it is to put like this and to go into the shower with this on your face, or to take a hot tub bath. Just to let the steam activate a little bit more.
And it feels so good.
The pear one is the only one.
Yeah.
How you say this beautiful?
No.
Oh, the pepper bean.
In French?
Oh, jojoba.
So it can be worked with your grains or without.
I can't believe I've never tried this. I always do the pumpkin and the cherry.
Favorite one, I always do this one.
The smell is like to die.
Yeah, there's a bit of a cinnamon smell in it.
Wow.
So
I love their feels. It's
like my go-to when I need a
I always do the cherry and the pumpkin.
The professional, it's the same composition, but it's 15%.
Lactic acid.
Yeah. So it's amazing how it works. And the professional one, we leave it for 1 to 3 minutes maximum.
Oh, okay.
And it can be boosted or not with the steam. As at home care, we do it in the shower for that steam. So it depends on like which skin you're working on. The very, very sensitive but dehydrated skin, we're gonna use it even in a professional, like Kibisa and Kibin treatment, we may use the 5%. But as a stronger skin or a client that comes very usually and we know her, we will do the 15%, which is amazing. So we can work or not those jojoba beads, depending on the skin. What is the other product?
We don't have any of the peels.
In treatment room?
Yeah.
No, I know you're not using the...
The plant cell...
Oh, plant cell booster? Okay. Because I
have that one.
Okay. The plant stem serum booster, you have the product.
Yes.
Are you?
Yes.
Okay. My cover went in my tea cup.
Oh no. Do
you want? I'll clean it after.
The list tissues there on the...
Thank you. I'll clean it in the Okay. Plant stem serum. It's a repairing booster serum. It's for all ages, well, I would say from 30, 35 and up, and has that boosting effect on repairing. There's a, I don't know if it's saying new book, Bugella, it just say butterfly bush stem cells. Some, in my book it says Bugella, it's an Asiatic plant. So those stem cells.
Oh yeah, Bugella. And,
oh, you have it there. Those stem cells will really help to enhance our natural healing process.
And heal.
Yeah, heal. And the other one, the echinacea plant stem cells, will help to boost collagen to produce a little bit, boost the fibroblasts to produce more collagen. So yes, it's anti-aging, but way repairing. So it's like a boost, after a certain period of fatigue or after medication phase, or like now
your
the season is ending, our skin needs a little boost, this one will give that repairing boost to the skin. And it's to be done as a cure,
okay.
Completely.
No problem.
It says only at night, but we can use it morning and night for that powerful boosting repairing effect.
Because like all the lines.
You're all set?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. And how they collect the stem cells in natural
Africa,
they call
the 6441.
Wound therapy, wound like a blister.
Wound therapy.
Yeah.
Oh,
okay.
When you cut yourself,
yeah.
You make a wound. It's wound therapy because they take the plant, the root of the plant, and they provoke, like they make little cuts, micro cuts, and that beautiful liquid that's come over to repair with powerful antioxidant effect and repairing effect. They take the stem cells from that healing liquids. So that's how they collect the stem cells.
Smells so good.
It smells good. It's very, very light to be used under any of our cream or any cream. We're gonna stay like in the real life. It can be if a client uses the Pure and Central cream, they can use that. I mean. The only way that we're not gonna put any naturopathic product under any other cream is when it's with essential oils. Because sometimes when it's full of essential oils, it can break down the biotechnology because it's biotechnology.
Yeah.
Yes, is this?
No, that's
the okay, which one do you have?
We don't
have the night.
The C15.
Okay, but the one before, was it the Night Refiner?
But I think there was one before.
Rose.
Whatever
Rose.
One we have.
Yeah, we don't have
the one before.
Rose. I'll just show it to you. That's another serum. Like, it's oil serum. As the carrot seed serum, seed oil. This one has that overall anti-aging effect.
You know where your rose is from?
Well, from the United States.
Absolutely. There's a shortage of rose hip.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Really?
Because Naturopathica is harvesting all the ingredients all around the laboratory to make sure to diminish the ecological.
Yeah.
How you say that?
It's not
different. Footprint. It's the ecological footprint.
That's what I meant.
Well, a lot of roses that I've seen, tried, used, or have a bit of a color to it.
Well, this is
but this
mixed
is,
with
yeah,
it.
Yeah,
this
sunflower
is the seed. It's not. It depends the way they're collecting it.
Yeah.
And
like
it's blend with
color.
The geranium and the everlasting flower.
But the rose seed extracts for the gel on the.
Yeah,
yeah,
so maybe
it's
not as much.
It's a different thing.
So sunflower seed oil is the base, pomegranate. Oh yeah, so it's really
and that said, the rose hip will have that like it's rich in vitamin A and vitamin E to repair the skin barrier and to help regenerate the cells. And the everlasting flower will have an impact on the overall melanin process to prevent and treat from disorder of melanin and prevent.
It's a really good anti-aging.
It is. This is our overall anti-aging serum oil because we will have the plant stem serum that will give a boost on the healing process and the vitamin C, which we'll see right after that. You all love.
Yeah.
The vitamin
so
C serum will work really on fibroblasts to produce more collagen, but it doesn't have that overall anti-aging action. As the geranium tube inside will go and reinforce the blood capillaries for permeable blood capillaries. So it's our overall anti-aging. And the vitamin C serum, y'all tell me?
15%.
What is the 15%?
Yeah, exactly. That's right. Because to be effective on anti-aging, vitamin C has to be between 10 and 20. So we put
right in the middle.
Right.
Exactly.
But is there a legal amount that you can't, like, I thought there was like a legal amount that like they can't make a certain
vitamin C, I don't know,
like
FDA or something like that, there's a certain maximum, but for sure over 20%, it will dehydrate the skin, it will be too harmful for the skin, so there's no need to put that much.
Love it and tingle.
Sometimes it has a different color. The ones you go, they had like really dark ones. Is that any reason? Like, I mean, make it or?
The dark one?
Yeah. Well, it was the same, but it has completely different color. Like
maybe the testers.
Okay.
Because the testers, as soon as we open the product and you have all those pictograms there, it's 6 months.
I don't think he
never lasts that long.
Because someone is using it, is using it in a month and a half, so it won't change color, but it might get a little bit darker.
Mine was a little orange, but it wasn't dark.
It was kind of, like, almost like the bottle, you know?
Like this one
that
here?
That dark?
No, from the shampoo. Like the next one, quite,
Yours was?
No, the one which was here. Because I was, then I was kind of,
this because if it comes that color, it's because the vitamin C is getting oxidized.
Yeah.
And if it stays on the shelf with
the
lights, with the heating, always pumping in out of the box, it can oxidize a little bit. It doesn't mean it's not good.
Right.
But the effectiveness, maybe it becomes a 11 or the 12% of activity inside. So that's why it's very important when you sell a product like that, to say to your client that he has to use it as a cure, morning and night for a month and a half, and then go back to their normal anti-aging. Using that all year long, some people do, I would, I love it, I would use it all the time, and my skin is not sensitive, but on the sensitive, that will be too much. It's better to make a cure of it, go back to other product, then come back. So we see that much difference. But I mean, if there's a client that wants to stick on it.
And it's a little bit drying, right?
Oh no, we're just doing training.
It has to be used with a cream on top because it's a serum, there's no nourishing, no moisturizing impact.
If you use the collagen serum under or hydration serum, would it kind of sell with this product? So instead of like the 15, it would have less because you put another serum under?
I would never put another serum under.
Okay.
But you can put another serum on top or a cream on top.
But not like, let's say, hydration serum, vitamin C and cream.
You know what, if you do hydration serum because the skin is very dehydrated, go ahead. You put your hydration serum, then I would suggest to wait a little bit, 5-10 minutes, to let the skin absorb the hydration, and then you can use your vitamin C, and it will reduce that little tingling action of it because you moisturized before. But avoid to use a serum, hydration serum, then put directly the vitamin C because yes, you will dilute a little bit. But if you let it absorb, then it will be perfect. So it could have been in the Brighten and Revitalize collection because we all know that vitamin C is amazing to brighten the skin and it will do. But why they had put it in the smoothing firm, it's because 15% is a very powerful way of stimulating collagen, new collagen in the skin. So it's in the anti-aging, but it can be sold to any skin ages. Mm-hmm. And it's one of the best product to boost like dull skin complexion or pigmentary stain. It's amazing, the vitamin C. Okay, are you on the Argan Peptide Wrinkle Cream?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
All right, perfect. This is our anti-aging warmature eye contour cream. in a beautiful mood too.
Oh, they love it.
It's all new, it's all fresh.
What is?
This one. The argan is not argan oil.
Ah.
No. It's argan stem cells.
Ah.
From the tree, not for from the fruit. So the argan stem cells will have an action directly on the, I don't know if it's the right way to say it, the fixation, no, the, to fix the fiber collagen right to the dermal epidermal junction.
Like repair it, no?
It will like fix the fibers correctly for a better communication between the epidermis and the derm and give that plumping, plumping and
cushioning.
Cushioning effect. Thank you so much. As the other ingredient, the matrixa that is inside, will boost the fibroblast to produce more of that new collagen. Mm. So it produces more collagen and the argan stem cells will help to fix them correctly to reondulate that thermal epidermal junction for that more cushioning effect. Because more we age, less volume we have, so that cream will help to create those volume to the skin.
Perfect. Can I hang up your doctor for you?
Yes. Puffiness, it says, how effective is it?
Good for puffiness because of the soy protein, the peptide, and it will help to drain the excess of water by stimulating lymphatic circulation. It's good for puffiness. It's not as good as vitamin K for circulator, dark circle, but it's good to drain. So it's an overall anti-aging eye contour cream. And it doesn't say for lips, on it, but please use that around the lips for those little lines.
It's very, very, very funny. Like I'm in public and I laugh out loud when I have. I just started it yesterday and my flight is delayed from here yesterday, so I'm actually almost done.
Would you need a 5 minute break?
Yeah. I'm good.
I'm fine. Mm-hmm.
You're okay?
Do you want to see if you need a break?
Any tea or something?
No, I'm okay. Because the tea is like getting like...
You promise.
You do?
I don't know.
I think it should be the drink.
There's some other cream.
Oh, good. I think that's good.
Oh my gosh, I don't know if I can get any more.
Can
I
move
this skirt?
Yeah.
It's pretty hot. Thanks.
Okay, so in the day cream. Well, it's a repairing oil cream. It can be used morning and night. Or just morning, because we're going to use the other one at night. But if you have a client that is not ready to invest for a 2-jar cream, the day cream or the regular rinker cream can be used morning and night. They both have that Matrixyl Synthesis. You see the Matrixyl? Did you ever heard about Matrixyl?
I have heard of Matrixyl, yeah.
It's one of the most effective ingredients for anti-aging creams. Because Matrixyl, it's a peptide that, it's an incomplete part of collagen, but work by chemical, work in laboratory.
Yeah.
It's made with peptide, with protein, so it's natural, but it's fixed in laboratories and it's like an incomplete part of collagen.
Okay.
So when it gets into the derm, because peptide goes very fast into the derm because they are protein, the fibroblast recognize that incomplete part of collagen as its own. And it boosts the fibroblast to say, oh my God, I need to produce more because what I did produce is not complete. It's like saying to the fibroblast to produce. So that's why from now maybe 10 years, this peptide, the Matrixyl, is the most common use and one of the most effective. But usually what you're going to hear about that ingredient, it's Matrixyl 3000. It's the one, the most common one. And Naturopathica, since about 2 years, that new Matrixyl Synthesis 6 has been released on the market, is using that one because it causes a little less inflammation and irritation to the skin. So when we talk, get Naturopathica of an holistic brand, but very effective with clean cosmeceuticals. It's an example of clean cosmeceuticals. It works very well. It gives like effective result, but without the irritation part. So that was about Matrixyl. So Synthesis 6, it's the new generation. So in the same as the eye cream, we will find the Matrixyl Synthesis 6, we will find the argan stem cells, and we will find in the day cream the Edelweiss extract plant stems for overall uniformity of the melanin. And in the night cream, we'll find all these ingredients plus retinol. So this is the day cream.
This is the day. See, we don't have the day cream, but I tried the sample of this.
Yeah.
And I love it.
Yeah.
So I think they should get the day cream.
I think to complete that anti-aging.
The day cream is like, it was like silk.
It's very silky, yeah. And it's like, the smell of it, it's like woody smell.
So this is
like
the day
very
one.
Yeah,
this is the day one. Like, it's like, wow. It's almost like a serum.
It feels so nice.
Very, very.
I had really like dry, flaky skin. Like I just went through like a phase of having really dry flaky skin, and really I took a sample of the C15 and the day cream, like it was like a sachet,
it's really
and
nice.
I used it overnight, my skin was just like perfect.
It is like a serum, like I use the heavy German cream, so I would put this like maybe underneath.
My skin is like velvet the next morning.
Yeah, you can put this underneath. Absolutely, or use it as a serum.
It's like really
It's like it has to be for every skin type, but the condition for mature skin. And the one with the retinol, it's a 3 retinol blend. Mm. They're all in capsules and liposomes, and they are released gradually into the skin to avoid that uncomfortable effect of the retinol. Because retinol is the acid part of the vitamin A. Mm-hmm. And it really boosts the cell regeneration from inside out. Appealing will do it from outside in.
Yeah.
And vitamin A will do it from the first layer at the dermal epidermal junction to boost that regeneration. But on a very sensitive skin, it can be sometimes a little bit like hard. Mm-hmm. So that's why being in capsule and release gradually, it really helps to absorb that effect of the vitamin A, but without that irritation.
And any percentage or no?
It's a little bit further in the book, but I can tell you there's a specific page on retinols. You will see it later in your book, but the percentage is
1.65%. Oh,
wow. Yeah, to be effective, it has to be between 1 and 3.
Yeah.
Between 1 and
3.
To
vitamin A?
Yeah. And now, even 1, it's a good concentration, and it's 1.65.
Yeah.
So it's very good.
3?
Yeah,
3 is a bit hard. I mean,
the only thing lots of clients are getting the retinol prescribed by the dermatologist.
Yes,
here.
But it's not the same because I had a it makes your skin dry and very flaky. This does not do that.
No, because it's in capsule and it's blend with other ingredients.
I don't like the dermatologist retinol.
I don't like it either, but as soon as they have it,
I
will not take this one because they say, oh, is it
And it has to be used at night for 2 different reasons. Mm. Do you know where we do have to use it at night?
But like
the retinol has to be used only
on its own. Like I don't know.
Why we use it at night instead
because
of
because it's repairing
sun.
Well, sun.
The
sun. Yeah.
Oh, the sun.
Because it's not making the skin photosensitized, but as long as it really boosts the skin regeneration. Our skin defense is a little bit less because the skin comes on a little bit more like thinner. And it's not the most important reason. The most one is that vitamin A is so sensitive to the sun. As long as it gets in contact with the daylight, it's degrading very easily. So that's one of the most reason to use it at night, because if we put it at day and we don't have a sensitive or a very thin skin, it won't get any like side effect. But as soon as we will go outside, and those little liposomes will open and liberate the vitamin A, and it gets in contact with the sun, it will stop to work. So if we pay for retinol, we want it to work.
So do you recommend using it alone at night, or can you put things on top of it, or what do you think?
I would put things
under.
Or a serum, or a booster, or the cell booster, or even, well, I would avoid vitamin C serum, because vitamin C is strong and vitamin A is strong.
Oh, I've been using them together.
Have you?
Yeah.
Absolutely. If your skin is sick,
take it. What about an oil underneath?
It would be okay. It depends. If it's a very, very light oil, like a rose oil, or I'm sure you have good quality, perfect. Mm-hmm. But not an oil that is too occlusive.
That sits on the skin,
Because if you want the other ingredient to go into your skin, it won't go. So
I've not been using anything. I've just been doing it with the samples I had on its own.
Yeah, that's the best way to do it.
Yeah.
I mean, it's effective by itself. You don't need
anything
to put something on it. And what is the next product in your book?
Sweet Cherry Brightening Enzyme.
Okay, so we're done with our anti-aging line. So there's three, well, you have two serums, so forget about the rosehip oil, you don't have it. But what is the main difference between the vitamin C serum or the stem cells boosting?
The stem cells.
The stem cell ones start to repair the outside of the cells.
It's like a boosting, boosting, repairing serum with that boosting effect on collagen. Mm-hmm. So it would work on the wrinkles, on firmness, but its main action is a repairing boost. Mm-hmm. A vitamin C serum?
Anti-aging, smoothing.
Yeah, because it boosts the collagen production very effectively. And plus, a very brightening effect on the skin tone. Because sometimes it can be confusing and then you have too much problem. Okay, this one. I will eat that one.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Do you remember what kind of acid there is in those peels?
Lactic.
Yay! This one has the highest concentration, because we want to work on pigmentary spots, hyperpigmentation, and dull complexion. Not dull. And the cherry extract too. I won't keep that.
That's so good.
The cherry extract will have that brightening effect. And I know you will laugh, resveratrol?
Shirley Temple.
Oh my goodness.
It's a very powerful free radical ingredient.
So good.
This has to be better.
Is it edible though? Probably the acid might be a bit irritating on the tongue.
So this one is 7%.
I don't know your skin. Oh
yeah. Yeah.
Oh, it's just very, very dry.
Oh yeah, it's chewed it up
1 degree. It smells too good. Do you have
like something? You got like a bit of cream on the bottom.
How long it has to be leave on the skin?
How long?
Yeah.
3 to 5 years.
Yeah. And the best way to use it?
Yeah. Before the shower.
Yeah, into the shower. Yeah. Or in a hot bath. Yeah. Or have the spa. And you remember for that before going out thing, or before wedding, or before a date, which would be the best mask to use after that one for that brightening boosting effect?
Oh, the white tea. Sorry, no, the white tea one.
Yeah, the white tea. Because of that brightening effect of the white tea extract, and because of the rosemary extract that gave that lifting effect.
So that would be like kind of help.
You have some like professional product, and then we go with the vitamin K. You like it very much, this one here?
Yes.
Yesterday, I was doing a training in Bolton, and it happens that one of the consumers get it when I was doing the training, and she says she's having very dark circles. She's been using this plus another like vitamin K serum under, and she said that she sees a nice difference on her dark circle, but she said, can I boost it in somehow? And now we're trying. I gave her the prescription of doing this vitamin K cream as a mask 2 to 3 times a week at night, just to put a little more thicky coat, leave in for 10 minutes, and just remove the excess before going to sleep to see if on a mask base it will look better effect. But that vitamin K has the power to chase that hemoglobin congestion. So we need to work on dark circles, circular dark circle. Mostly more on dark circle than on puffiness. For sure it will help to drink the puffiness, but it's for a dark circle. And you can sell it as a CC cream. Because it's a corrective cream and will do a camouflage effect with that yellow color. And there's some mica and silica little particles inside to reflect the light and to get that camouflage.
There we go.
It's
everywhere. No, you're good.
All right.
I know you can feel
the micro little particles inside. And because of these particles, it's better not to use it on top, just under the eye, because these particles will stay. We don't want the mica and silica to penetrate.
Yeah.
They're too big anyway. But with the sebum and during the day, if we put it there, they might get into the eye with hours going on. So that's why we use it under. And I can't wait to have the news from that client.
Yeah.
It uses it as a mask, but I'm sure it will work more effectively because of that occlusive effect of reticular. So it can be used alone or over any eye opening. Let's say if I'm young and it's very dehydrated and I want to prevent from first sign of aging, I would use the Primrose Eye Control Cream as my eye cream all around, and then just under to help with my dark circle, I can put this on the top of it. Or the same with the Argan Eye Cream, or by itself. And that last product in brighten and revitalize, it's the vitamin C lotion. Concentration is not written, but it's between 2 and 3% of vitamin C. Sorry?
Okay, I thought it's a little bit more.
No, yeah, I thought it was three, yeah.
It's between two and three concentration. And in that percentage of concentration, it won't give any anti-aging effect, but antioxidants, free radical scavenger.
Especially oil in that moisturizer.
So this is a preventing anti-aging moisturizer. So light. It's an amazing one for summertime. Because it's very, very light. And wearing it under the sunscreen will help to boost the protection of the skin. Because sunscreen or physical filters will block UVA and UVB. This one will protect from free radicals. So it's not a sun protection. It will just boost the anti-radical protection of the skin.
Yeah.
We sell this one as a serum.
It's a lotion. For Canada. Mm-hmm. Okay. Yes. Like, absolutely. Yeah, it sinks in and it, like, I think here you need.
And then maybe next time when you come.
In summertime, the initial. I mean, it's enough protective and renewal protection to be worn alone. But if you sell it as a serum and a cream on top, that would be great. It's a good one for men's care.
For the macrodermal.
Oh, yeah. I love it. It smells fruity. It's very light. It's protecting.
I think
very
in
nice
3 weeks, it will be perfect.
Yeah.
It's like need maximum four. Because you're still going to be in the salon for 6 weeks. You know, we love it at home.
Are we okay? Three more products.
Yeah. But I have a surprise for you after I show you new products that are not even released.
Yeah, for this one. Okay. Enjoy. Let's see how that
The Thanksgiving in the jar.
Okay.
Yeah.
Or the
and the Halloween in the jar. And just give us a call.
This is for combination
and
oily, dry skin.
The green to use.
And the percentage of lactic acid inside. It's 3%.
Like that, just to like the way your skin will absorb whatever it's need.
And
so good.
And people say, why only 3%? We want to exfoliate because the pumpkin extract have a lot of vitamin A.
Make that in mind. Okay.
In natural way in the pumpkin. So the vitamin A in the pumpkin will boost that only 3% of lactic acid. So it's absolutely for oilier or acne skin. And plus there's some plants inside. It is basil, rosemary, and I miss one in my head.
Oregano.
That's the thing. That will control the sebum production and will have that antiseptic action too on the skin. Thank you for the help.
Sorry, I'm just sniffing it.
Beautiful. So exactly, 3 to 5 minutes under the shower. How many times a week? It depends on the skin. It depends on the client. A thicker skin will say 2 to 3 times a week maximum.
Moisturizer is awesome.
Like, it depends. If there's a lot of inflammation with acne skin, we might go for 1 to 2 times a week, depending on the skin. The musk. Without looking at the ingredient, what would you say there is in the musk for oilier skin?
Clay.
That's it. There's clay. There's the white clay and the green clay, bentonite and kaolin. And there is some moss extract, which is very rich in sulfur and antimicrobial. And there is calendula. So it gives that like absorbing, cleansing effect, but with the anti-inflammatory too. And it's not a clay mask that will dry and dehydrate the skin.
It used to be a little tiny box.
Yeah, more
like
that.
It was thick. Yeah, it's thicker than
this.
Yeah. It's very user friendly.
Yeah, this is much, I like this that you can use it. So. The other one I think was just a spot treatment.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, that, I love the smell of it.
That's the sulfur.
That's really?
Yeah, the sulfur and the musk.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
Is there another maybe in the Inkilis ingredient? It's
not
very
sulfur.
Flowery.
That's sulfur.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's sweet.
So I have
that's
another sulfur anti-blemish thing. Stuff
is
it
like
smells
80.
Like that. Mm. It smells very similar.
And it can be mixed together with the aloe replenishing mask.
Mm.
Both together after
the honeysuckle bit.
Is that sweet? Sweet smell.
Or maybe the calendula that is mixed with it. Calendula is very smelly.
Yeah.
But mostly it's the sulfur that we smell. And the moss is that little green thing on the rocks and on the tree.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
In French, we say sphaigne.
Sphaigne.
Oh, you say the word. <Thanks. laughs> Because I did the translation in French, they say mousse.
Oh,
mousse. But mousse is foam. It's,
okay.
Well, it's not
mousse.
Mousse,
yeah.
Mousse. It's not a good translation.
Yeah.
So when I teach it in French,
yeah.
I say it's not mousse, it's like sphaigne. Rosemary the rosemary oil reducing moisturizer, which is the moisturizer for those acne and oily skin, with the alpine willow extract that will control the sebum.
Collagen gel and nail acid.
Rosemary that will have the antiseptic and very like uplifting effect. So antiseptic. Control the sebum, and there's some hyaluronic acid to give hydration, not moisture or not any nourishing. Because sometimes oily skin, they're using very hard products on their skin.
Yeah.
It reacts on the other side. And you know what is a good oil for them is the carrot seed oil. It's amazing, but at night.
Yeah.
Because they don't want to have any oily stuff on their skin. But the carrot seed oil at night will really helps to calm down the inflammation and helps to dissolve those sebum clot into the pore. You don't have the carrot seed oil, but it's a good mix to be used at night.
Onyx, I haven't been trained on that.
No.
And that's
all
it.
That.
Yay! Can we have a
Yay. We want to know what this is.
Yeah. Now there's a trial box that is on its way to the urine sample office for them to try, experience it, and it will be out on the market March 14th. It's called Bio Energy Leaf Cream and Serum. So these two products will soothe any overstressed skin, fatigued skin, skin that needs a bit of like energy boost to revitalize those skin. But it has that lifting effect with other ingredients. So we can call these two products our urban serum and cream. We have the cassis that it's a good antioxidant, but this one goes a little bit further in that complex just to
have a great day.
Boost into the mitochondria of the cell, those ATP that gives the energy with a yeast extract. It will really boost the consumption of oxygen by the cells. to reboost all the function of our cells. So it's very, very specific on oxygenation of the skin to give back that energy to the cells. So it will go, it will complete the smooth and firm line because actually it has a firming effect, but it can be good for any skin type of age. Oh.
On your skin, right, on your face. Like, and we're in
a spa.
This is a new product, bioenergy. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so first ingredient is the yeast extract that will give that oxygenation process consumption into the mitochondria. It boosts the oxygen into the fibroblast fibers, the fibroblast mother cells from up to 17% more after 15 days. So really boosts the oxygenation. And then there is a complex of copper. You know how these minerals are effective on the skin function? So it's a complex of copper blend with amino acid, two kind of amino acid, it's proline and lysine, to boost the collagen production for that lifting and cushioning it.
Cushioning.
I remember. So a mature skin will provide from that lifting effect, plus the luminosity, plus the energy, plus boosting
use them in conjunction, yeah?
Yes, exactly. And the last ingredient inside, which is only in the cream, it's raspberry ceramides to repair the cell membrane.
Nice. What's the price point compared to, like, the origin and the vitamin C?
If I remember, the serum, I think it's 65.
Oh, nice. So yeah.
No, the full price.
Oh.
So it's 120 something.
Okay, so
in
it's similar to the argan.
Yeah, 120, 125 cream and serum. So it's not for, like, young skin.
Yeah.
Will like it. But I mean, there's so much ingredient like biotechnology inside that we have to have the need for that energizing and boosting and lifting.
So we are still benefit from using one on its own as opposed to two in conjunction, or is it like sort of have them together?
All together, it will give that very boosting effect because.
Right.
Some of the ingredients that the copper complex with the amino acids that are probably more concentrated into the serum because it goes right in. And there is the ceramides like raspberry ceramide in cream that you're not gonna find in the serum because it has to get over to repair those membrane cells. So, but if someone wants to try one, not the other one, problem. If they're on another cream and you want to make that introduce the serum before the cream, we can go with that. I mean, it would go very good under the argan stem cells and Matrixyl cream. That would be good because one will work more on the lift and energizing and luminosity, and the argan will work more on deep wrinkles. So both together can be good. Or even this BioLift energy under the vitamin C serum, that could be great because both together will give that amazing glow and rejuvenation of the fibroblasts for collagen. But I would say if you like propose this product, try to propose it all together. I'm on it for a week now. Mm-hmm. Because last week I was in the United States, I was in New York City, and Barbara, the founder and the owner of the company, she said, bring this to your place. I want this is my own product. they're not released yet. And try it. And I'm using it now for a week, and
I wouldn't say I see a big difference on firmness because I don't have a big lack of firmness. Mm-hmm. But the luminosity, the pink color on my skin, the microcirculation enhancement, I see what a difference. It's like it removes that gray Dalton tone that we have at the end of the winter. So
that will be your new baby suit.
Yes.
Yeah.
And you don't have any body product. Okay.
Well, yeah.
We used to do body treatments.
We used to have the espresso mud scrub.
Did you have the? I think you had already the muscle arnica muscle.
We had that.
Gel. And they've changed all the. Well, for your pleasure, if you want to play around a little bit in these product. Oh. These. Are the alchemy? Now they come in like a kit box like that.
Yes.
But it will be sold separately as essential oils. It's not to put on the skin. It's just to inhale, place a drop depending your mood, on certain part of your like on the temples. On your wrist too. There's some different one. I'll let you experience it. There's the chill aromatic alchemy.
Got the chill one.
This one will so help to calm and unseat.
What's the best one for headaches?
I would say the chill will be good. The lemon verbena. There's some narrow leaves.
The
inspire will help to.
Are we gonna sell this? Probably not.
It's mostly to work in treatment room, but eventually if it's something that you would like
some
to get
would
from
buy
retail.
It. I do.
Yeah.
I do.
But
we've
got retail kids.
Essential oil. Oh no, we used to. We used to have like little peppermint.
Here there's
yeah.
the
especially
the ingredients
in
each
little bit. Oh, neroli.
What's the name of the new products that you were talking about?
The BioLift.
BioLift.
BioLift Energy.
Is it on the website?
Not yet.
Oh, okay.
No, it's a pre pre teasers.
I think I can't have every of these
products. Oh, yeah, I could just buy them all.
This was ice fist about one.
Literally the.
You
will put myself to death. Oh, I know. I love it.
This is a little bit like
sweet
orange.
Oh, God. Please. I know it.
Have you been to Sage?
No, I'm purposely avoiding Sage.
Because
you see how I buy when I'm here?
Yeah.
I walked in
there and I was like, oh my God. And then I walked out. Neroli is fantastic.
I asked Jean to make a
neroli
body
blossom,
oil.
Lemon verbena and chamomile.
Oh, yay!
You have to remind Jean.
Where is that neroli body oil?
Neroli is fantastic.
Oh, yeah.
It's my health.
What am I?
I would put that on my face.
So this one is, you can do like,
so
you put two tree drops into the palm of your hand.
God.
And you inhale it.
It's just to die for.
You can put 5 to 6 drops into a bath and then to
relax.
Nice.
And then lock my son's door and my daughter's
door.
Or
you can even put two to three drops on a paper tissue and put it on your pillow to help you sleep well at night. So there are beautiful things.
Totally.
I can smell something else.
How much is one of those?
The kit? For retail, it's $114.
So bad for all of them.
Some consumer will pay for that.
Yeah.
Some of them
for sure.
Not. But it depends.
Oh
it's not to put
just
in the burner.
Smell.
It's very
treating, yeah. wellness, yeah. aromatic approach of like different
I can't get enough. It's so beautiful.
So there it is.
So
now you will have the hard work of choosing the product and letting me know so I can send it to you.
It's so hard. I don't know what to pick. That's so... It's Ori.
It's a new one.
But the new one you need the two, right? So. Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, I think for me it's between